Hi everyone, thank you for joining in. I would like to present you my review of Zoom H6 Black Edition Multitrack Audio Recorder. So without further ado, let's start from unboxing. There is not so much to say about packaging. It is very usual packaging for Zoom products. Simple carton box, but works very well, as an almost in any case. Inside the box we've got manual, Black Edition microphone capsule, 4 alkaline batteries and Zoom H6 Black itself. I'll start from this thick package of paper printed manuals and other stuff, which includes authorization codes for Cubase LE and WaveLab LE, two fantastic pro audio applications from Steinberg, a further microphone capsule, basically the same standard XYH6 only in black, and H6 multitrack audio recorder itself. There is nothing more, no cables. Let's peel this screen protector off. It sounds nice. As you can see, there is no difference between previous model besides color. It is all black, now in some sort of Darth Vader look. It's made out of durable, heavy-duty plastic with some sort of metal reinforcement here and there. Dials feels good, strong enough for frequent use, in my opinion. One can use just usual camera strap with it, which makes it way more manageable in certain situations, as in case with recording boom on location or recording of the interviews. Now I would like to have a couple of words about the lack of cover on capsule connector. Personally, I found strange that Zoom did not include the simple thing in package. It surely could be very handy when one not using capsules. Happily, I've got some other Zoom products. F1 field recorder, which has perfectly compatible microphone capsule connection cap, which I'm currently using with my H6. In my opinion, this is necessary piece should be included in the package. Just saying. Okay, now let's take a better look at supplied black version of XYH6. There's also new capsules available. I think it could be a nice idea to include one of those new models with black version of H6 in some sort of package. Just a thought. As you can see just right over here, black is definitely looks good on it, but there is no further difference with previous generation of XYH6. The good thing is that this capsule sound exceptional. Recordings made with this capsule are very high quality with low noise and good balance overall. There is so many ways how one can use H6. From high quality music recordings and studio use to podcast recordings and video live streams. And here we've got specifications of H6. So now let's put it all together and get it through some sort of tests. Here goes SD card and rechargeable batteries, the only batteries I'm using, to be honest. Let's fire it all up and take a short look at the menu. In case if the capsules is connected, recorder recognize it and adjust in itself to the situation, as in this case with XYH6 connected, you can see first two lines of input level from stereo microphone on the display. Slight push on knob on the side and we've got menu. I have to say that this is very easy to operate menu. It is absolutely not difficult, even if it has several sub-layers in almost every rule, it has a very easy logic to it. Regarding overall quality of experience, I would like to say that this is top-of-the-line product, so as expected, it is very capable. It can do many things, including simultaneous multi-track recording and USB audio. So far so good, now I would like to get some work done with it. Oh yes, almost forgot. Zoom did not include any cables with Black Edition of H6. So it is good to have one good USB Mini B to standard A connector ready by the hand. I'm using my H6 quite extensively, primarily a standalone recorder for different kind of audio recordings in stereo as well as in multi-channel and mono, and also as USB audio interface for my computer and iPad. Let me show you. So here's my not very typical setup for work with iPad, which is good for this particular moment. Whereas I'm using H6 as an USB audio interface with stereo microphone capsule connected, lavalier microphone through XLR adapter, and I've got stereo pair TRS jacks on input 1 and 2. Of course my H6 connected to an iPad through an Apple USB 3.0 adapter. And hitting on Cubasis on iPad, choosing new project to work. Meantime, checking up on volume levels, so it's eliminate surprises. Okay, let me show you what is going on iPad. We're creating a new track, choosing the input channel on H6, loading it all up with the monitor on, and then again for next stereo track and again, so we've got all connected channels in use in our project, which makes it 5 channels connected simultaneously. And again, going through the inputs, right here just in order to show how it is done. I have to say that Cubasis on iPad is a very intuitive piece of software. Works almost exact as desktop application with the same high quality results. So now, as you can see, we've got 2 stereo pair running, one more mono track with 1 channel from the lavalier microphone. Overall quality of H6 also something to make a note. It's nearly impeccable. Heavy duty hard plastic build and metal faceplate always works well, in my opinion. Everything here is showing off quality. Nevertheless, there is still some sort of little regrets about previous reincarnation. Unfortunately, it is not available anymore. Although one can buy all of the available accessories separately, it could be nice to have it all in one package, as before. Regarding situation with accessories, really have to point out that the new version, in my opinion, seriously lacking it. H6 has 4 XLR line ins, 1 3.5mm jack line out, 1 independent 3.5mm headphone line out, and stereo capsule connector. Very impressive combination in my opinion. H6 is the best portable recorder on the market at this point. There is nothing better. This is most capable tool, the Darth Vader of the audio recorders. I'm seriously enjoying using my trusty Zoom H6 every time. I've got this recorder for around 7-8 months, and after many hours of work with H6, I'm absolutely sure it is the best one. Looks like we can make a recording. And last but not least, let's change it all to 24-bit and 96 kHz. It's also switching H6 to high resolution quality. Very nice hardware integration. Indeed. Now recording. I forgot to load one track. Okay, now all of them together. So that was easy, right? H6 is also works extremely well as an element of the video recording setup. You can connect for up to 6 channels of high quality audio through XLR inputs to your H6 and send it out through the 3.5mm jack to the camera, as well as all 6 separated channels recorded in multiple files. Worth to mention that you also can connect one of many microphone capsules, including shotgun available from Zoom itself. Another nice way of using it would be streaming video or recording podcasts. Zoom H6 also has line out volume correction, so you can adjust level to lower outputs as required on some cameras. Sometimes I'm also using my H6 for digitalizing vinyl. Now my turntable connected to preamp, and from there it goes straight to H6 through TRS connectors. Works very well for me. Have to say that dials on H6 is very well adjusted or tuned, so I can get almost perfectly equal volume on both channels without any difficulties, which is quite nice obviously. I always use H6 with display on medium brightness and can confirm that one could get hours and hours of multi-channel 96 kHz 24-bit recording with 4 Eneloop Pro AA-AA rechargeable batteries. So Mr. Darth Vader, may the force be with you. There is many similarly or higher priced audio recorders on the market, but no one of them offers that much for this money. Some of them could have slightly better audio, like DSD codecs in case with Sony, or 192 kHz 32-bit floating as with Tascam, but you cannot connect 6 microphones to it or work as portable interface with multi-channel 96 kHz 24-bit audio in and out, period. There is not so much more to say about. And that would be all for now. Thank you for joining in. Thumbs up if you liked it. Please subscribe and see you all next time.